Alright guys, so let's work on those cutoff moves. The cutoff is a key progression from the underarm pass. So underarm pass leaders is stepping off to your left diagonal. One, collecting your feet on two. You'll notice that we pick the hand after we've stepped on two. Three and a four, the follower travels underneath the arm. And then we anchor step five and six. So a cutoff is a redirection halfway through that move. So the followers shouldn't feel any difference until we actually show them on three that we're going to send them back to where they started in the move, okay? Let's just turn around and face the other direction. I want you to see the point of contact, okay? So it will be hidden slightly as I first make it here, because it's behind my body, but you'll see it now. You see I'm cupping just the lower part of the rib cage. The shoulder blade is also a good area, but I find this has become my sort of go-to favorite position. We would definitely suggest to avoid the hip. This can allow for oversway, and we don't want to be too high and too close to any of the followers' softer areas, okay? So using the back of the rib cage is a very secure space that we feel a lot of followers feel very happy about the leaders making contact there.
Yeah, leaders, I want to mention just a little bit more than that, is to make sure that your fingers are actually round, cupping around the side of your follower and your palms on the back. If you move to the back, that's very likely the follower is going to rotate, slip straight into reverse whip.
Sorry, my target is the seam line of my partner's shirt. And I don't want to meet with the tip because that can feel like you're jabbing, but with the pad of the fingers. Okay, and that's going to make for a softer reception. So I'm going to kind of stay out of the way a little bit for you here so you can see it. So you see that the shape is already open. And then as I move past my partner, my palm cups around the shoulder blade or the lower part of that sort of lateral muscle.
Followers, you can help by showing what part of your body you don't mind your leader placing his hand, okay? So that's going to be on a count two. You're going to see me start to show my leader my right side. I still try to travel forward, but I'm traveling forward with contra body movement.
If you watch Fab, this is Fab's general progression through all of her past patterns. So when we get to the cutoff, it's only natural for that to happen, shoot and and if you were thinking, every time I do a side pass, there's a potential that it could be a cutoff, then you've got to sort of show that area as an opportunity for the leaders. If you run past it, the leaders would probably have a little bit of a hard time showing you what the move is. And one other thing for the leaders, and then we're going to maybe move on a little bit, is keep your footwork underneath you. Okay, we need the steps to be really, really small here. Equally for the followers.
Yep.
This would be not such a great execution of a cutoff. We see a lot of people moving out to the side. And then from here, you can see obviously our posture isn't great. That's not going to lend itself to good balance and good timing. So keep for small footwork, that should allow you to create a nicer sort of feel and look through the move. So one more time, our basic one, two, three and a four, five and a six. Okay, so they're made up, that move is made up of walk, walk, triple step, triple step. We're going to be playing with a couple of other things within these little pattern combinations. So we're also going to do a single weight change, which is a step tap, and then we're also going to be doing a delayed single, which is a tap step. Okay, and we take out the taps. All right. So if we've confused you, I'm sorry. Let's show you what we mean. So this is our next variation. We're going to do two walks, then we're going to do a single weight change and hold it. One and hold the two. So that's where we might tap. Do a start step sort of thing, single with a tap, single with a tap. But we're going to do single with a hold. And then Fab's going to release that toe because she's going to need a bit of space for me to move her onto it. So that's traveling anchor step, followers. Don't get caught out. You won't do another anchor step on the spot when you arrive there. Okay, so let's count this. This goes one, two, three, hold the four, triple out, five and six. You notice that I just moved back just a little bit to accommodate my followers' space. Let's just show you from the other side. So we've got one, two, three, hold four. You see the heel of my right foot's off the ground, the heel of Fab's left foot's off the ground, so we know which foot we're gonna step with next. Okay, again, sometimes you'll see people, they'll get here and they'll be split weight, but then they forget which foot they're gonna do the next step with. So if I release onto that foot, then it's very clear to me, and it helps my partner to be clear to them that which foot they should be standing on as well. So ideally, we might like to try and get that to hit an accent in the music. If you're not sure what all of that means, then try and find the beginning of a line in the lyrics when the singer starts singing. And we'd look to do a sugar push first. So one, two, three and a four, starting with the lyrics. Then we can do that here, and then we count 7, 8, one, hold two, triple three, and four. If you keep that cycle going, the next time I think you will land on a 5, and that will be a reflection of the 1, so you should still feel like you're doing something that's connected to the music. Okay, so let's move into the other variation. So this is more leader stuff, but we've got one or two things that the followers can be sure of incorporating as well. Okay, so we're going to do now another cutoff, 1, 2, and we want to do the 1 for the followers, and they're going to hold their 2, and the leaders are going to start moving. So when I move leaders, I don't move the follower, I've just got to move me, and I'm going to replace my hand. So you see my left hand is now slightly on the back of my partner's shoulder. I'm going to just lightly keep contact as I move away from Fab. As I get to the last step, you'll notice that Fab's recognizing what's about to happen. She's like, oh, he's going to lead the next move. So she makes the weight change, and then we're ready for whatever comes next. Let's say a sugar push. Okay?
Should I get up? Should I?